بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وآله الطيبين الطاهرين Inshallah, what I'm going to do is to share with you some of the ideas that the late Sheikh Dr Shomali, rahmatullah alayh, has mentioned in his book Munyat al-Murid fi Adab al-Mufid wal-Mustafid, which is a book on Islamic education and pedagogy. And then inshallah we can receive your questions. I sent you also the text that I'm going to reflect on. It's in Arabic, may help some of you, but I'm going to interpret and to translate and explain inshallah. The preface or introduction is starting like this. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. الحمد لله الذي علم بالقلم علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم. Shaheed Thani rahmatullah alayhi, who was killed by the radical, you know, people who were against, you know, him because they knew that he is a Shia scholar. So he was for some time in Shamat, you know, what is today Syria and Lebanon, teaching in some Sunni circles also. And he himself is also from Jabal Amel, from southern Lebanon. So it is said that this book is compiled by him when he was teaching in a place in Baalbek. Anyway, he himself explains the reason behind compiling this book. He first starts with praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who taught us how to use the pen. Allama bil qalam. So he uses a some of the passages from the Quran for this introduction. As you know, in Surah Alaq, we have this ayah, Alladhi allama bil qalam, allama al-insana ma lam ya'lam. Inshallah, he will explain it later. Wa sallallahu ala habibihi wa abdihi wa nabiyyi. So, after praising Allah that has taught us how to use pen and has taught mankind what they didn't know, he sends his salutations to the beloved of Allah and his servant and prophet, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who is afdal man ullima wa allama. Prophet Muhammad is the best person who was taught. Allah is muallim, and the best learner was Rasulullah. And also among human beings, he is the best teacher. Of course, Allah himself is the first teacher, but after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the best teacher is the Prophet. So the first mu'allim is Allah, and the first learner is Rasulullah. Among these learners, Rasulullah is the best teacher also. وَعَلَىٰ آلِهِ وَأَصْحَابِهِ. Also, we send our salutations to his family and his companions, al-mu'addibina bi'adab, those who were equipped with the manners of Rasulullah. So those companions that followed the path of Rasulullah had the same commitment to the virtues of that Rasulullah taught. We send our salutations also to them. Wasallama. So we ask Allah to send salutation and peace to them. Sallallahu ala habibihi wa abdihi wa nabiyyi. And then we say wasallama, and peace to be also sent to them by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Amma ba'd. After this line of praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and sending salutations, then he starts talking about the aim and purpose. He says, Amma ba'd. Fa'inna kamal al-insan. This introduction is very beautifully written. I wish you were all able to understand Arabic. I try my best to explain for you, but if you would be able to read yourself, it would be better. Amma ba'd. Fa'inna kamal al-insan. Annama huwa bil-ilm. Very important statement. Perfection of human beings is with knowledge. Knowledge is very important. Just in Montreal, you know, when we're talking about knowledge as a requirement of imamah, you know, we said how important is knowledge and how Allah proved the ability and capacity of Adam to become Khalifatullah, vicegerent of Allah, by referring to his capacity for knowledge. Shaheed al-Thani rahmatullah alayhi says, فَإِنَّ كَمَالَ الْإِنسَانِ إِنَّمَا هُوَ بِالْعِلْمِ. The perfection of man, human being, is only with knowledge. الَّذِي يُضَاهِ بِهِ مَلَائِكَةَ السَّمَاءِ. It is with the knowledge that human beings can resemble the angels of heaven. So it shows that the angels are able to function because of their knowledge, but man has the capacity of learning even more than angels. Of course, this is a potential and we should actualize it. وَيَسْتَحِقُّ بِهِ رَفِيعَ الدَّرَجَاتِ فِي الْعُقْبَةِ. With this, human beings can qualify, can deserve high ranks in the hereafter. So if you want to have high ranks in the akhirah, you need knowledge. But it is not only showing its result in the akhirah. مَعَ جَمِيلِ الثَّنَاءِ فِي الدُّنْيَا. Also in dunya you would be beautifully praised. You would be praised by people of the world. Even people who are not religious, they would praise scholars, knowledgeable people. Everyone loves knowledge. وَيَتَفَضَّلْ مِدَادُهُ عَلَىٰ دِمَاءِ الشُّهَدَاءِ. With knowledge, the ink of human beings becomes more important than blood of the martyrs. You know, if you just imagine the significance of shahada, you know, martyrdom, and the blood of martyr, which is coming from the depths of the heart of someone. You know, there is no way to underestimate the blood of the martyrs. But still, the ink of alim is preferred and raised over the blood of the martyrs. Because if the ulama are not there, who, first of all, how these people are trained and educated to become ready to give their life for the sake of Allah? And also how they can make sure that they are giving their life for a good cause? Many people think that they are, you know, for example, working for the sake of Allah, giving their life for the sake of Allah, and they are confused. So the ink of alim is showing the way to proper service to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and proper sacrifice. وَيَتَفَضَّلْ مِدَادُهُ عَلَىٰ دِمَاءِ الشُّهَدَاءِ وَتَضَعُ. He is using, you know, all these based on the hadith and Quran. وَتَضَعُ الْمَلَائِكَ أَجْنِحَتَهَا تَحْتَ رِجْلَيْهِ إِذَا مَشَى. Exactly, this is in Hadith. The angels would put and spread their wings under the feet of Alim when he walks. Angels who are very special, very close servants of Allah, Ibadun Mukramun, they are honored servants of Allah. But when they know how much Allah loves ulama, they also show this love and humbleness towards ulama. And they spread their wings under the feet of Alim when he walks. وَيَسْتَغْفِرُ لَهُ الطَّيْرُ فِي الْهَوَىٰ. Even the birds in the sky ask Allah for forgiveness of this person, on behalf of this person ask forgiveness. They ask Allah to forgive him if he has any mistakes, any sins, any shortcomings. Of course, such people are not sinful people as such, but we are possible to make mistakes or forget things. So they ask forgiveness for them. وَالْهِيْتَانْ فِي الْمَا. Even fish in ocean, in sea, ask forgiveness for these people. And then, وَيُفَضَّلْ نَوْمُهُ لَيْلَةً مِنْ لَيَالِيهِ عَلَىٰ عِبَادَةِ الْعَابِدِ سَبْعِينَ سَنَةً. It's really amazing. One night that this alim sleeps, the sleep of alim in one night of his nights is preferred over worship of a worshipper for 70 years. If you have two people, one is a worshipper who doesn't have knowledge, is ignorant and is worshipping. And there is an alim who has studied, who has worked, and now in the night he sleeps. He's tired, he sleeps. Of course, he does Salatul Layl maybe, he does, you know, other things. But maybe sometimes he's sleeping part of, you know, some of the night. Anyway, his sleeping is preferred to and raised over worship of Abed for 70 years. وَنَاهِيكَ بِذَٰلِكَ جَلَالَةً وَعِظَمًا. And this is enough for you to understand the glory and greatness of ilm. لكن but لَيْسَ جَمِيعُ الْعِلْمِ يُوجِبُ الزُّلْفَ. But it is not that all different types of knowledge would lead to zulfa. Zulfa means nearness. Nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No. You know, the Quran says that when idol worshippers are asked why they worship idols, they say, مَا نَعْبُدُهُمْ إِلَّا لِيُقَرَّبُونَ إِلَى اللَّهِ زُلْفَ. They used to say, we only worship them to take us nearer to Allah. Zulfa means nearness. لَيْسَ جَمِيعُ الْعِلْمِ يُوجِبُ الزُّلْفَ. It's not that every type of knowledge would lead to nearness to Allah. So, it's important to know what type of knowledge. But also, وَلَا تَحْسِيلُهُ كَيْفَ اتَّفَقَ يُثْمِرُ الرِّضَى. It is not also every type of acquiring knowledge would bear the fruit of pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, what to study and how to study, both are important. The first says there are some types of knowledge which lead to nearness, and the second says there are some types of learning and acquiring knowledge which can give the fruit and thamare of the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بَلْ لِتَحْسِيلِهِ شَرَائِطِ. there are some conditions for acquiring knowledge. وَلِتَرْتِيبِهِ ضَوَابِتْ There are some regulations for arranging that. وَلِلْمُتَلَبِّسِ بِهِ آدَابٌ وَوَظَائِفٌ The one who is equipped with knowledge has to observe some manners and he has some duties. وَلِلْطَلَبِهِ أَوْضَاعٌ وَمَعَارِفٌ And there are some conditions, situations, and some teachings for how to seek knowledge. It's not, you know, easy, you know, to gain knowledge. You have to know where, how, and then after that, what are your responsibilities? لَابُدَّ لِمَنْ أَرَادَ شَيْئًا مِنَ الْوُغُوفَ عَلَيْهَا Whoever is interested in having some knowledge, شَيْئًا مِنَ some knowledge, he has to know, he has to be aware about these things. وَالرُّجُوعُ فِي مَطْلُوبِهِ إِلَيْهَا And he must refer in his pursuit, what he is pursuing, what he is after, to these things. He cannot ignore these important conditions and manners and duties and regulations. لَأَلَّا يَضِيعَ سَعْيُهُ وَلَا يَخْمُدَ جَدُّهُ So that his efforts would not be wasted. Unfortunately, sometimes we make efforts without achieving anything or without achieving great. And your jed, your industrious and hard working, should not go down. If you see that you are on the right path, you are getting knowledge, you are learning, you are getting closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you will keep your interest. Otherwise, you may gradually become, you know, unfortunately, loose and, I don't know, relaxed and lose your momentum. وَكَمْ رَأَيْنَا بُغَاتَ هَذَا الْعِلْمِ الشَّرِيفِ Shaheed al-Thani, rahmatullah alayh, he says, how many people, it means we have seen many, كَمْ رَأَيْنَا, no, how many people we have seen, he means that he has seen many people, who were بُغَات, بُغَات means seekers, Bagi ibtigha, one meaning of ibtigha means to seek. Kam ra'ayna bughat hadha al-ilm al-sharif? How many seekers of this honorable knowledge we have seen in our life? He refers to his experience of people of his age. But this is a common experience in all ages. Maybe even his age was better than our age, we don't know. He says, how many seekers of this noble knowledge we have seen that da'abu fi tahsilih they tried they had the habit of you know learning acquiring knowledge ajhadu nufusahum fi talabih they were not even lazy they worked hard they exhausted themselves they undertook you know serious job in searching for knowledge and reaching wanailahi and reaching knowledge. So although they really looked for knowledge and worked hard for gaining knowledge, ثُمَّ بَعْضُهُمْ لَمْ يَجَدْ ذِلْذَٰلِكَ طَلَبِ ثَمَرَةً But some of them didn't find for that search any fruit. There was no fruit, no result. وَلَا حَصَلَ مِنْهُ عَلَىٰ غَايَةٍ مُعْتَبَرَةٍ Neither they achieved any fruit, nor they reached any valid end. They didn't achieve anything. They didn't reach anywhere. وَبَعْضُهُمْ حَصَلَ شَيْئًا مِنْ فِي مُدَّةٍ مَدِيدَةٍ طَوِيلَةٍ كان يمكنه تحصيل أضعافه في برهة يسيرة قليلة. Some of these people, they achieved something. So some people didn't achieve anything. Some people achieved something, but over a long period of time, في مدة مديدة طويلة, over a long period of time, they achieved what they could achieve many times more in a shorter period. Very beautiful in a sentence. He says, كان يمكنه تحصيل أضعافي. He was able to achieve multiple of that, many times more than that, في برهة يسيرة قليلة, in a short period of time. So for example, he spent 20 years, 30 years, but what he achieved was possible to achieve just in few years. وَبَعْضُهُمْ لَمْ يَزِدْهُ الْعِلْمُ إِلَّا بُعْدًا عَنِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى. And some people, unfortunately, their knowledge didn't increase them anything except going away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So some people didn't learn, some people learn a little, some people maybe they have learned, even maybe they have learned a lot, but they have gone away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَمْ يَزِدْهُ الْعِلْمُ, didn't increase him knowledge, إِلَّا, except بُعْدًا, being far, عَنِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى, far, being away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَقَسْوَةً, it added قَسَاوَة, hardness of the heart. وَقَلْبًا مُظْلِمًا, and a dark heart. Because knowledge is something very important, and if you don't know how to use it and how to respect it, it becomes something that can make your situation even worse. Like any ni'mah, when Allah doesn't give you ni'mah, that's easier. When you have the ni'mah, if you are not responsible, if you are not grateful, if you don't know how to use it, your situation becomes even worse. So these people have been given knowledge, but unfortunately they didn't know how to use it. They were not careful, so they became even worse. قَسْوَةً وَقَلْبًا مُظْلِمًا مَعَ قَوْلِ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ. Although Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَهُوَ أَسْتَقُ الْقَائِلِينَ, he is the most truthful of the speakers. Allah says, إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهِ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءِ. The only people who really have awe, have fear out of respect for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, are those servants of Allah who are ulama, who are learned. So we expect from ulama not to have qasawatul qalb. We expect from ulama not to have dark heart, not to be far from Allah. But unfortunately, there are people who have knowledge, but they are not true ulama. Because Shaheed Sani says, they didn't observe these manners. وَمَا كَانَ سَبَبُ ذَلِكَ وَغَيْرِهِ مِنَ الْقَوَاطِعِ الصادت لهم عن بلوغ الكمال إلا إخلالهم بمراعاة الأمور المعتبرة فيه من الشرائط والآداب وغيرها من الأحوال. And the reason, the cause for this and any other قواطع, barriers that block them, didn't let them reach perfection, the cause for this and all other barriers that stopped them reaching their perfection, was nothing except ikhlaluhum. They did not do justice. They did not observe. They did not make sure that they implement those things which are needed those conditions, sharait, those adab, etiquettes and manners, and other situations and conditions. So it's very important that we know what to study, how to study, and make sure that we perform our responsibility and duties towards ilm, so that inshallah then we will be blessed with so many merits that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to Ahlul Ilm. وَقَدْ وَفَّقَ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ بِمَنِّهِ وَكَرَمِهِ فِي مَا خَرَجَ مِنْ كِتَابِنَا الْمَوْسُومِ بِمَنَارِ الْقَاصِدِينَ فِي أَسْرَارِ مَعَالِمِ الدِّينِ لِتَفْصِيلِ جُمْلَةٍ شَرِيفَةٍ مِنْ هَذِهِ الْأَحْكَامِ مُغْنِيَةً لِمَنْ وَقَفَ عَلَيْهَا مِنَ الْأَنَامِ. He says, Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave me tawfiq that in the past, in our book called Manarul Qasidin fi Asrar Ma'alim al-Din, Manar, you know, a place from which light comes, you know, like in the masjid, you know, there is Manar. So this book is called Manar, a place from which light comes for those who want, who seek secrets of the teachings of religion. He says, in that book, we discuss these things, which was a detailed discussion. وَقَدْ رَأَيْنَا فِي هَذِهِ الرَّسَالَةِ إِفْرَادَ نَبْذَةٍ. In this book, Munyatul Murid, we want to bring some of those conditions and etiquettes and what comes as duties. So, some of it, which would be beneficial, inshallah ta'ala, لَمَنْ تَدَبَّرَهَا. For the one who would reflect on it, we will mention. So he had a previous book, more detailed. He wants to bring some of it here, so that this summary would be beneficial. Nafi'a, inshallah ta'ala, liman tadabbaraha, for those who reflect and ponder on them. Musalatan lahu ila bughyatihi, would help him reach his aim, idha ra'aha, if he observes it. Ra'aya means if he observes it. And then he says that the one who reads this book has to make these ideas somehow inscripted on the pages of his memory. Very beautiful. You know, نَقَشَهَا عَلَىٰ صَحَائِفِ خَاطِرِهِ. What you read here, you should make an image of it or impression of it on the pages of your memory. Like, you know, you inscript something so that you don't forget. وَكَرَّرَهَا, and repeats it. These things are not things that you listen or read once and then you leave it. مُسْتَنْبَتَةً مِنْ كَلَامِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَىٰ. These ideas that I am sharing with you here are taken from the word of God, وَكَلَامِ رَسُولِهِ وَالْأَيْمَةِ عَلَيْهِمُ السَّلَامِ, from the word of Prophet and Ahlul Bayt, كَلَامِ أَسَاطِينِ الْحِكْمَةِ وَالدِّينِ وَالْعُلَمَاءِ الرَّاسِخِينَ, the pillars of wisdom and religion, and the ulama who are established in the religion and knowledge, and, you know, ulama al-rasikhun that the Quran talks, al-rasikhuna fil ilm, those who are established and rooted in knowledge. وَسَمَّيْتُهَا مُنْيَةَ الْمُرِيدِ. I call this book مُنْيَةَ الْمُرِيدِ, the hope of the seeker, means the seeker of knowledge, fi adab al mufid wal mustafid, those who yearn, those who seek, this is their hope with respect to the etiquettes of mufid, the one who benefits, and someone, the teacher, and mustafid, the one who benefits from the learner. So mufid means who teaches, and mustafid is the one who learns. وَأَنَا أَسْأَلُ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى مِنْ فَضْلِهِ الْعَمِيمِ وَجُودِهِ الْقَدِيمِ أَنْ يَنْفَعَ بِهَا نَفْسِي. He says, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from His inclusive favor and from His eternal generosity to benefit with this myself. First of all, I am in need myself. وخاصتي, and the people who are close to me, وأحبائي, my friends, وَمَنْ يُوَفَّقُ لَهَا مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ, and every Muslim who would be given the tawfiq to observe these things, وَأَنْ يَجْزَلَ عَلَيْهَا أَجْرِي وَثَوَابِي, and to make my reward, inshallah, for this great, وَيُثَبِّتَ لِي بِهَا قَدَمَ صِدِّقٍ يَوْمَ الدِّينِ, and make my standpoint the standpoint of truthfulness and honesty, and inshallah firm. So give me a firm, truthful standpoint on the Day of Judgment. Truly he is generous and he is noble. إِنَّهُ جَوَادٌ كَرِيمٌ وَهِيَ مُرَتَّبَةٌ عَلَى مُقَدَّمَةٍ وَأَبْوَابٍ وَخَاتِمَةٍ. This book is designed in the way that it has an introduction. Apart from this foreword, there is another introduction, there are chapters, and there is a conclusion. Okay, I stop here. I think this was a good, you know, introduction. By itself had lots of important ideas, but also gives you an idea about the book. Maybe inshallah next session also I will carry on with some of the materials from this book. Thank you very much for your attention, and now inshallah we can proceed to the next part of the program. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alam.
So Sheikh, now the next session is the QA.